Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Azure Seas of an Unknown Planet. I am the Eidsmeister, and this is another construction episode. And it appears the results of the poll are in. You guys have voted, and the result is that this construction, or the next construction to be made, is a defensive structure, which is a drone hive. Basically, a structure that spawns and deploys, as well as maintains, many little support drones. Alright then, I guess this is very fitting, since there have been some changes to blueprint spawners recently, which will make this structure even more interesting. But before we go into the construction, I have a few issues to move out of the way. First and foremost, I might have to lower your expectations here a little bit. This upcoming structure, this drone hive, won't be the absolute destructor of death and doom. No, it will not be this. It will not be very effective in outright destroying other units, simply due to the fact that I'm quite limited in the amount of weaponry I can fit on these easy-to-deploy and quick-to-deploy drones. So, I have chosen to make this a support structure, and therefore, the weapon assortment has to be adjusted as such. Okay then, enough talk. Let's begin the construction. So, before we begin the construction, there are some points I have to clarify. And let's start with the actual block or unit that will be spawning those drones. The vehicle blueprint spawner. This particular construction element has experienced an update as of late. I'm sure some of you can recall that the vehicle blueprint spawner used to be capable to spawn either 10 constructs at once and preserve a maximum of 10 constructs at once. And once these constructs have perished or have been destroyed, the vehicle blueprint spawner wouldn't be able to renew those. And even if you were playing the campaign and moved a vehicle that has this blueprint spawner on it in and out of battle, it would not be able to update, meaning to reset the blueprint spawner to its original state, so that it would be once again able to spawn new constructs in a new battle. This has been fixed now, fortunately, I have to say, and we are even able to set the number of spawns to preserve for this blueprint spawner, which, for those who don't know, spawns to preserve means basically that this blueprint spawner will try to spawn as many units in play as it can, as indicated here by the number, so this would be 10. And once this this blueprint spawner has spawned 10 units, it will stop spawning those. If some units get destroyed during the battle, it will try to replenish these units up to a total number of 10 spawned by this exact blueprint spawner. So, now we can increase the limit to a whopping 100, and max value means infinity, so we can spawn an infinite amount of drones now. As much as fun as this sounds, let's be honest here, this wouldn't be very viable in a battle, and I'm sure my hardware setup would appreciate it if I don't fill the entire battlefield with tiny little drones. So, spawns to preserve will most likely be set to a number of 5, let's be reasonable. And max lifetime spawns, this is interesting. This is how many spawns this blueprint spawner can spawn in a lifetime, which means once it has been placed, the lifetime is set. And this I will set to 100 as well, meaning it can spawn an infinite number of blueprints in its lifetime. However, it will always keep no more than 5 blueprints alive to avoid overflow. Alright? Alright. So, then I've given it some thought on what to construct as a weaponry for these drones. Since I'm very limited in size, this also means I am very limited in component complexity. So only a few weapons can be considered to be mounted on those drones. As I said, this is going to be a support weapon, so I would like to have most of these weapons to carry a modest or rather sizable EMP charge, my go-to support weapon here. So missiles are of course the best choice for this. They can carry a number of EMP charges, are easy to set up, easy to replenish, and well, they don't take up a lot of volume for the firepower they deliver, that is. So here's an example, maybe for a small launcher, for a torpedo launcher. Yes, I'm not limiting myself to drones which can only attack surface or aerial contacts, mind you. No. And a large rail launcher here using a magnet EMP bomb. Now, the thing with this is very expensive. I will probably set up a separate blueprint spawner for this that only spawns one of those drones and is inherently tied to the spawner's own material storage so that it doesn't empty itself. Empty its material storage with the spawning of those bomber drones. Then we move on to simple weapons. Now, it is only logical that one would mount simple weapons on these smaller drones, and I have opted for the most effective and most usable among these. And those that don't shatter my eardrums. Looking at you, simple lasers. So, the simple weapon grenade launcher uses APS, basically, what are they called? I forgot the name. Ammo customizers, yeah, here. Ammo controllers and ammo customizer modules to define a shell which then can be fired from this grenade launcher. It is limited in shell size, although it should be quite useful with a magazine of 30 shells. Yeah, I can see this being quite nice. I've also employed this weapon on the Devastator attack bomber, and yeah, it functions very well. Next up, we have the shard cannon. This would make a fine addition to some kind of sniper drone, highly accurate, 3 shells in a magazine, and decent firepower, I would say. Let's have a look at the stats here. Kinetic damage 1000, armor piercing 30. That is enough to destroy most, blocks. Not most blocks, most components or armor blocks. Mind you, if armor stacking would be out of the picture here. Maybe not metal, yes, but wood and the like, certainly. And, then we have another simple weapon, the revolving blast gun. It's quite interesting. Think of it as a automatic shotgun. While its shells do, well, let's see here, not so much kinetic damage on their own, it does spew out quite a lot of them, though it has a rather lengthy reload cycle. And last but certainly not least, a particle cannon. Yeah, strange choice for this one. I wanted to deliver an EMP jolt, which it does quite well. However, since I'm limited in size, this particle cannon isn't exactly powerful, and the drone carrying this one will also need to replenish its energy reserves not by itself, but rather from the spawner itself. Meaning I have to make sure that this drone does not stray too far from the spawner and that the spawner has a wide range of material, material replenishment area where it can replenish other systems and other units. So, yeah, that's it as some kind of preliminary thought to the weapon systems which I'm going to use. And let's get started with the actual construction of a prototype for a drone. Since we are probably placing this drone spawner on land, this will of course be a flying drone. Let's do this. Right, starting out now, and there are a few things to consider. One thing to consider is that these drones have to be constructed mid-battle, which means I have to make sure that they are, one, fairly cheap, reasonably cheap, and two, that they are made up out of as less blocks as possible to basically decrease the construction time. Now, I have a few drones already in my arsenal. They ECM drones, for example. I never did anything with those. And these, what you can see on the carriers, what I call it, not sprite fighters. Those are the old ones. No. Where are you? Oh, they are the vector drones. These Dorito-looking fellas. 300 blocks are way too much. A cost of 9,900 materials, however, is almost acceptable. Almost. Let's see if we can get that even lower. So, let's begin the construction of a basic drone chassis. And for this, of course, I would like to first have a little thought about the power plant we are going to use. Fuel engines are fairly power dense. I could even make that better. Look at this. Each drone has, once it has materials, let me just. There we go, giving commodities to this one. Actually, let's give it a little. One moment, please. I need this little constructor to accept commodities. I mean, resources, I mean, not commodities. No, please don't break apart or upon impact. Thank you. So, we have a fuel axis of 50. This is the default fuel axis for every vehicle, as well as 50 ammo axis. This means let's see how much power I can get out of this cylinder here before the fuel consumption gets too high and I have to place an actual fuel tank. This will also this engine here will power basically the jet engines. Yes, I will make those drones flying ones. This is the only course of action here to take, as the high mobility will make it easier for those to traverse terrain and basically land. So, this doesn't sh say anything. Oh, there we have it. Materials per second. Not enough cooling. Cylinder can overheat. I know, I know. I will install another one of these. There we go. No, I know. its form is a bit weird. it certainly is. However, I have managed to achieve a stable flight with this, is what I was going to say. Never mind. Never mind at all. This is basically a basic jet fighter drone. I have stuffed a lot of components into there, as well as this missile controller. Now, what I have to do next is hook up this missile controller to actual missile silos. Not silos, launch pads. All right then. This should be easy. Okay. So, I basically have to. Oh, here's a PID. Where are those components? Now, I could use what are they called? This transmitter and receiver system. That would be much easier on here. Yeah, indeed. And I shall use this system. So, let's cover this up for the moment, and then... missiles. I need missiles. Oh, this is a good spot for this. Okay. Just making a few adjustments here and there. And then this little mistake of nature is ready to go, I hope. Okay. Why so many? I don't know. Come on. You tell me why so many. So, the transmitter transmits to receivers. Okay, yeah. Remember your radio-controlled equipment here. Okay, launchers. Some basic launchers, rail gantries. No, not another rail gantry. An invisible rail gantry. That is needed. Oh. That was the 1 meter variant. Okay, much better now. I will place some ducts here later, and let's see. I mean, it does look a little bit weird, doesn't it? Yeah, it certainly does. So I've placed one fuel tank, and I may have to place one ammo box on this, or maybe not. We'll see. We'll see about that. Now I do not have a staggered fire add-on, which is probably totally irrelevant at this point. Yeah, about that ammo box. Maybe I can put it in here, or maybe I cannot. We shall see. But for now, I think I can finish this up. And this is then a basic... Oh no. Help. This is so stupid. Look at this. Mistake of nature. okay. Placing a few blocks here and there. Okay. Yeah, I had an idea where I was going with this one, but looks like it didn't turn out that well. Maybe. Yeah, armament. Let's see what kind of speed this thing can achieve. Although I will do some speed tests after I have finished up the front. And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. The mistake of the fighter drone has now been completed. Well, almost. At least in its functionality. Aesthetics-wise, there are some things that have to be corrected. But this is basically a fighter drone. We have 169 blocks. More than enough, still alright to be constructed by the drone spawner. It is very compact in here. I've also used some more ammo boxes. They shouldn't be able to create a catastrophic chain reaction. I say should, but hey, you never know. Might need some more fuel though. So, I wasn't able to reach my goal of not relying on any systems. Any additional fuel and ammo boxes. One other goal that I would like to achieve is use as many, as less small blocks or single blocks as possible. Basically, 1 2-meter block can armor up a 2x1x1 meter segment, and making it very, very useful in terms of construction speed. Okay then, better to construct one block rather than construct two blocks, isn't it? So yeah, I present to you with my fighter drone. Ah, that is so sad. okay, first drone done. let's have another one. I will test them later and refine the design later. Let's just get this over with. One more important thing. EMP. There we go. EMP protection, I mean. Yeah, let's get this over with. So, before we begin construction on the next drone, it is time for a little combat test. The drone fighter will now be facing a Falkenheim. Yes, face it. Now. Something to note here. I have not installed any balloon deployers on this little drone. Since it is entirely made out of light alloy, it will float quite nicely and can get itself out of the water on its own, basically. No, it's not invulnerable. Drone fighter has successfully downed the Falkenheim, I think. Now then. This looks like... This has a very unique flight profile, I have to say. Now, it is in the water now, and it should get itself out of the water eventually. Eventually. So about the balloon deployer thing. this was a mistake to assume that it can get itself out of the water on its own. Or maybe not! Prove me wrong! Haha! Nice. So yeah, it's a unique profile, is something I'm quite fond of. It is certainly very unique in that regard. Though I might want to increase its pitch authority just a little bit here in the PID section. Let's give it a little bit more pitch. PIDs is something I have to fine-tune at a little bit later, maybe. But yeah, enemies have been defeated, and the little drone is now... hey! Maybe this isn't so bad after all. I had my doubts. Next up, bomber drone. So, beginning the construction of the bomber drone now, and I can see, safely say that some of you may now see a certain recurring design feature with these drones here. Just putting it out there. Yeah, the bomber drone will be much larger than the fighter drone, of course, probably having more blocks than it as well. And I will not be using a, this propulsion system, a central forward drive. Where is my fighter? Oh, there it is. I will be using, most likely, the hover function for this drone. This drone will hover above the target and drop its payload on set target. This is the plan, at least. So, let's install a few more engines in here and worry about the actual setup of the interior later. That sounds like a very, very intelligent course of action. Yeah, about that. Maybe this is better. And then, yeah, I need to make sure that there's no space wasted in here. So I do need ejectors, since I'm not using the bomb drop feature that you find in, rail gantries. This should be enough space for the AI. And some other components as well. And yeah, Before you kick loose an absolute shitstorm, I'm using even symmetry here, just for the sake of mounting this large gantry in here. Okay, let's see. So these here should be set to... Ech. Oh, caps lock. Pusher. Then we have a few rollers as well as pushers. And here as well, they will now pull double duty. Let's see how this works in just a second. And then we here we have the pitch control. This is a thruster craft. There we go. Much better. Now, what's left? Pitch control here. Yeah, maybe. I need some kind of turning capability. So... Yeah. Your control will be here. And, yeah, then we'll see about some other components, I guess. Huh. Well, it does seem to fly for now. Somehow. Where is my little fighter, actually? Oh, yeah, about that. Just stay there. Yeah, so it does seem to fly. I have rearranged some of the insides. I've not added any ammo boxes, since the one bomb I'll be dropping is this one. And it only costs me... magnet... 48 materials. So, yeah. I know. It's 50 ammo per minute, and I need 17 seconds to reload this. Still, maybe... You know what? Maybe I could add one or two ammo boxes in here. Granted, okay? Maybe I could do this. Just one ammo box. There, I hope you're happy now. By the way, how much do you weigh, ammo box? 40, okay. 40, oh, there we go. So the weight distribution is even as well. I've added a few PIDs. Detection systems, yeah, about those. I've not added those just yet. Actually, can I? Oh, this does not work. I have plenty of engine power left, by the way. Those, what do I call those? Those engines, those jet engines, do not use that much engine power on this one. So, might as well use some shields. Width, height, let's go for 9.5. This is a very nice number. Yeah, like this. Maybe this. Zero. And there we go. At least the AI is protected. Actually, I could basically even do it like this. Yeah. Okay, then minus. And there we go. Much better. And the effect strength can be turned up all the way to maybe... Well, actually, make it 5. You know? Go all out on this one. And yeah, as you can see, almost 200 blocks. Still, this bomber drone will take some time to construct. And I guess its effectiveness has to be measured in combat. Speaking of combat, could be ready any second now. Is there anything else I would like to add to this? Other than some surge protectors. Yeah, maybe something here in the back. And... basically... You may think now, why would you add those shields without any control blocks to control if they should be turned on or off? Well, the answer to that is fairly simple. Let me explain. You see, This unit will only be deployed when there is an enemy present. Therefore, the shields will always be on when an enemy present. Get me? As this unit is deployed then. So, I don't need any control blocks. Okay. There we go. Main engine is protected as well. That's what I like to see. So... Wasn't there something else I have to test out here? No? And here we have the bomber drone once again, currently engaging a marauder. And this is basically its final form and attack pattern. Yeah, so dropping a magnet mine, I've added an additional missile module. It has now an explosive charge as well, though I think I need to increase the magnet's range maybe, since this drone does try to hover above the target. However, it cannot achieve well, a point where it stands perfectly still above the target. So let's see if we can increase this to not 200 meters. 200 meters is actually my altitude. that would make for some interesting yeah, friendly fire incidents. Imagine a magnet coming back up, because something to avoid. Something which I've only also done is added ion engines. This drone can now propel itself quite nicely out of the water on its own, thus doesn't need any what you call it, balloons. Yeah. So yeah, it's basically finished, apart from some cosmetic changes. Yeah, there we go. A bomber drone. What do we have here, by the way? We have a cost of 10,000, yeah, so I thought. And blocks 210. Okay. Probably going to deploy two of those at once. It's getting quite costly. But yeah. It does its very best to hover above the target and then drop a magnet mine on it. Now, I do have to fix these face-planting tendencies on the fighter drone, however. This is getting on my nerves. So, next up would probably be something with particle cannons, though. I'm not sure if this is even viable in such a on such a small scale. Therefore, I guess the next drone will feature the simple weapon grenade launchers, as well as what are they called? Shard cannons. Yeah, that's the word. Shard cannons. Just making some final adjustments to the sniper drone. I have for now shelved the idea of mounting those simple weapon grenade launchers on one of those vehicles. For the simple reason that I've not found a way to basically have the drone close to the target and not get shot down instantly. The same goes for the particle accelerator cannon. Those are shelved for now. Maybe I'll mount a pack on a bomber drone variant. We'll see, we'll see. But for now, this this is the sniper drone. A frontal broadsiding drone that will stay at distance and basically point all six of those shard cannons towards the enemy. I just have to get it under control for now. It does seem to be quite twitchy and erratic. Maybe this has something to do with those pitch thrusters all being at maximum output. I have installed PIDs. And yeah, there we go. Much better. Maybe some roll control would be nice, and then we would be all set, I guess. Yeah, roll control. Let's see. It's jet engines. And there we have roller preset. Let's. Oh, no. Not. This is always way too much power. I mean, yes, power is good, but too much power makes this uncontrollable, even with PIDs. And so, yeah, this needs to be basically standing perfectly still. These shard cannons do not have a lot of traverse speed, and they need a long time to aim. So, the less it moves around, the better. Okay, then. They lock to close this here. And maybe finish up this section back here, although I do not need that many engines in this section. Yeah, this should suffice. Basically, give me one of those. Come on. Come on. There we go. Much better. And that's it, basically. They are set up correctly now, and all that's left to do is maybe tune the PIDs a little bit. We are ready for a test run with this little drone here. I'll be once again spawning a Marauder. The target dummy of choice for smaller vehicles. Okay, just have to see if I can put this wireless transmitters and maybe an additional block here in front of the AI. And this should be functional for now. However, I need to make sure that I have yaw control enabled as well. Yaw is quite difficult to balance on this one. All right then, I guess you are ready. Ready to fight. Yeah, detection systems are online. I have still some other drones around here, so let's spawn a Marauder. Well, I say spawn a Marauder. I have spawned a Jacobs Folly. And it is firing. Is it hitting? I don't know. If you see kinetic damage in the top right corner, there we go. Then yes, it is hitting. It stays at range, and it does this fairly well. Though, to be honest, it is still way too twitchy for my liking. As you can see here, it doesn't quite stay on target that much. There we go. Do those have a recoil? That's interesting. Yeah, we have racked up 30k of kinetic damage. And as you can see here, this Jacob's Folly is getting pelted quite nicely by this little sniper drone. Yeah, those shard cannons, although being simple weapons, are quite useful. I have seen this a lot, actually. What is the bomber drone doing? Nothing. Why aren't you doing anything? Most interesting. Anyway, sniper drone is fully operational. And yeah, I guess I can deploy five of those with the spawner. Speaking of the spawner, I guess this is it for now. We have the drones, we have the weapon systems, however, we need means to deploy them and to supply them. So, next episode will be the construction of the spawner, then the adjustment of blueprint spawners, and basically testing the whole system and the layout there in battle. Hui. Yeah, anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this little construction episode of me making some quite uniquely looking drones, and I hope I see you next time on the azure seas of an unknown planet. Take care, and goodbye.